praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise God Almighty.
Hallelujah.
The topic for today's Bible debate is faith. When we talk about faith, do we know what faith really is? What is our definition of faith? Faith is a connection between us and God. There's different elements to faith, which is belief, trust, and confidence. In terms of belief, do we believe that God exists? He's a God that we have never seen, but we see his handiworks. With faith, we believe in him. The book of Luke 17, verse 6, makes us to understand that faith, even if you have a faith that's as small as a mustard seed, you will ask or you will command a tree to be uprooted, and it will be uprooted and planted into another place. This is what we call belief. Okay. The second element is trust. Trusting in the Lord. God is a jealous God, and his first commandment was that we should have no other God before him. This is because if you have faith in God, what else are you looking for? There are many other gods out there, but just have your faith in God. Have trust in the Lord. The book of Psalms also, chapter 20, verse 8 to 9, makes us understand that some trust in chariots and horses, but they are brought down and they fall. Mm-hmm. The chariots and horses that they're referring to is the small gods of this world. Even though the small gods will give you something, it's not long-lasting. They will give it to you with so many terms and conditions. They'll probably say to you, if I do this for you, you're not allowed to put your feet in water, or something that is absolutely impossible for you to do. Even you that they've given it to you won't have peace of mind thinking, how would I maintain what this small god has given to me? But those who trust in the Lord will stand upright. God is the God that giveth to you, and he never takes it away from you. God gives it to you in his own time. You might think that, okay, it's taking long, how long is it gonna take? But God's time is the right time. Trust in the Lord. We will never fail. It will always make us stand upright.
Amen.
The third element is confidence. Having confidence in the Lord. The book of Hebrews, verse 4:16, makes us to understand that you should come boldly to the throne of grace, that we may obtain mercy and find grace to help in the time of need. In the time of need, if you call upon God, he's the only one that can answer. He's the only one that has all power in his hands. He's the one that's created heaven and earth, and with him all things are possible. You have to have confidence in the Lord and in the Lord to be able to command and to decree. It's like knocking on the door. If you don't have that confidence to knock the door hard enough, nobody's going to hear you. So you have to have that confidence to knock hard on the door, and it shall be opened unto you. And it's also, without confidence, it's like going to war without any armor or without any ammunition. If anyone shoots at you, you'll be running and dodging the bullets that they've shot at you. But if you have confidence in the Lord, the Lord will give you a helmet, he will give you a bulletproof vest, he will give you all the armor that you need. Even one of those big revolvers that you need, that even if you press it once, you'll have 100 bullets coming out of it. This is the type of confidence that we need in God, that we know that yes, if we go into war, all the bullets that the enemies are shooting will go directly straight back to them.
Amen.
I'm going to talk about Abraham in the Bible. I'm sure we all know how the story of Abraham, but for the benefit of those who don't, I'm just going to give you a brief summary, and then we'll go into how the Lord tested him. God told Abraham to get out of the country, that God wanted to bless him. God promised to give him a son through his wife Sarah, who was barren. This promise seemed impossible simply because Sarah and Abraham were both old. Sarah was in about her 90s and Abraham was about 100 years old. So even when God told Abraham that he's going to bless them with a child, you sort of think, okay, at this age, that is it even possible? But with the faith that Abraham had in the Lord, God did it at the end. This I want to say because God sent three men to Abraham, and the Lord was amongst them. And Abraham entertained them, did everything that he wanted to entertain them and to welcome them. And as they were leaving, one of the men said, by this time next year, when I come, you will have a baby, your wife will bear a child. Sarah was in the behind the tent, and she laughed, thinking that at this age, what am I going to do with a child? Is it possible? Is the Lord going to listen to my cries? But God did it. If someone can read the book of Genesis, verse 22, verse 1 to 3. We're going to cut it a bit short because of time.
Genesis 1.
Genesis chapter 22, verse 1 to 3.
Mm-hmm. Oh, sorry. And it came to pass after this thing, mm-hmm. that God did tempt Abraham,
yes.
and said unto him, mm-hmm. Abraham, and he said, behold, here I am. And he said, take now thy son, thy only son Isaac, whom thou lovest, and get thee into the land of Moriah, and offer him there for a burnt offering upon one of the mountains which I will tell thee of. And Abraham rose up early in the morning, and saddled his ass, and took two of his young men with him, and Isaac his son, and clothed the wood for the burnt offering, and rose up and went unto the place of which God had told him.
The Bible there makes us to understand that God told him, Abraham to sacrifice his only son, Isaac, as burnt offering. How many of us can do this? How many of us have the faith in God that if God says to you to do something, despite the fact that you're doubtful, would you do it? I know it's difficult for me, even though I've got three children. If God even tells me out of the three, take one of them and sacrifice them, I don't even know where I'll start. So talk less of Abraham's only son that God told him to sacrifice. Where would you start? What would your attitude before God be if God told you to do such a thing? But with the belief that Abraham had, he listened to the word of God. He didn't even wait until the week after. If it's us nowadays, we'll say, oh, Monday, I need to go and meet a friend. We're going for lunch. We're going for dinner. Tuesday, I'm doing my nails. I'm doing my hair. We'll just give all sorts of excuses that we'll satisfy our own self and say that, oh, even on Saturday, it's my sister's birthday. Would I be able to, I need to go for that birthday party. I just cannot do without being there. These are the worldly things that we put before Christ. You that are preparing for a birthday party or to do your hair and nails, you don't know what's going to happen to you on the way to go and do your hair and nails. But when God says to you to do something, it's only right for us to know the reason, even if you don't know the reason why. Just trust in God, because he's the one that's always there for you. He's the only one that can listen to all supplications. He's the only one that can do whatever we want in our life. My sister, please, if you can read verse 6 to 13.
And Abraham took the wood of the burnt offering and laid it upon Isaac his son. And he took the fire in his hand and a knife. And they went both of them together. And Isaac spoke unto Abraham his father and said, my father. And he said, here am I, my son. And he said, behold, the fire and the wood. But where is the lamb for a burnt offering? And Abraham said, my son, God will provide himself a lamb for a burnt offering. Mm-hmm. So they went both of them together.
That makes us to understand that Isaac didn't even tell his son that he was going to use him as a burnt offering. If it was us, we'd be shouting, we'd be running helter-skelter. Oh, God has told me to do this, God has told me to do that. I don't know what kind of God I'm serving. We would have said so many things that we would have offended God. But he was calm. And he said, even though Isaac asked him that, Dad, we're taking all this wood, we're taking a knife, but where is the ram that we're going to offer for sacrifice?